Do you ever feel like having that massive connectivity can be almost a detriment because we're always distracted by all these things that are going on around us, right? It's hard to stay focused. And, you know, again, I've just got all these friends, all these different places, and it's hard to tell who's actually genuine or not. Do you have any recommendations for that?
Absolutely. You can't find outside of you what you don't see inside of you. So the three things that we need to know inside of us is our own signal, the strength of that signal, the spectrum of our signal of who we're trying to reach and resonate with. And then three, the clarity of our message. What are we trying to do? What's our what? Not our why. The why will come when you know your what, by taking inventory of your values every day, not being afraid of being a hypocrite. So I think if you understand what's inside of you by taking inventory of your personal, experiential, giving and receiving values, you are only going to be more excited to have a wider spectrum. Where people get in trouble is where I got in trouble when I was young. I wanted to please everyone. You know, I could go to a party, I was a complete chameleon. Oh yeah, I love that. Oh, I hate that. Which one are you? You know, and I would look and feel lost. And I think that's what happens a lot of times today, is that everyone feels completely lost, separate, and anxious because they're trying to please everyone and they're overwhelmed, like you said. Whereas I look within, and because I have control of my mindset, because I have control of my heart set, and I know my values within, I allow that huge spectrum of 4.4 billion people and growing every single day to hear my frequency and be attracted to me. And I am very critical with those people that are aligned. So I have a great variance chain of feeding. It was told to me when I was young, you know, either people put weight on or take weight off of you. I have a variance chain. People in variance degrees feed me. In variance degree, I'm going to feed them. People in variance degrees don't feed me. In variance degrees, I'm going to engage with them. People that bleed me in variance degrees, I'm going to let them fall away, all the way to actually take activity to fire them from my life. So that feeding chain, from those who feed you to those who bleed you, allow you to send that frequency and attract those people and qualify and vet them in order to effectuate the most productivity, accessibility, and gratitude in your life.
Wow. Okay, so this is really interesting, and because sometimes the people that are most important to you, right, that are going to feed that variance degree, they tend to get left off to the side. I mean, I sometimes struggle with this. I've been married for over 5 years now. I've been with my wife for over 12, but sometimes she'll say things to me like, "Mark, I feel like you're somewhere else. You're not being present here with me right now," and that's a concern. Right? Because I'm building this side hustle. We're building these businesses so that we can spend more time with our family. But do you ever feel like that's a struggle? And how can we navigate that balance?
Oh my gosh, I've struggled through that for years and years and years. And I've come up with the best solution that has worked for me over the last 13 years. I've been married 23 years. I've known my wife since I've been 4. So that's 48 years. I've been dating her for, you know, almost what, 28. So we're a long time thing. And I was a moron and an idiot because I didn't follow this direction. Like anything else, 2 minutes a day is worth more than 2 hours on a Saturday. I vacation every day of my life. I meditate every day of my life. I spend a minimum of 30 minutes a day with my wife every day, 7 days a week. I spend a minimum of 30 minutes with my 10-year-old son. I spend a minimum of 2 minutes with my 3 teenage daughters, a minimum of 1 minute. Why? Because 2 minutes a day is worth more than 2 hours on a Saturday. When you have that consistent, persistent relationship, when you're there, I just went through an executive coaching with a very, very successful person who's having the exact same challenge, right? That his wife is not secure in the fact that their relationship's where it is. So she's actually utilizing activity in order to prove that he loves her. In other words, qualify that she's a priority. The only thing your family should not be a priority over is your health, because you can't give what you don't have. And if you don't take care of yourself, you're never going to take care of your family. So me, prioritize my adaptable routine as a minimum of an hour a day on my health every day, no matter what, before I do anything else, then the minimum of time with my family, then a minimum of my time studying. Studying is the mathematical equation of luck. It's what I pay attention to plus what I give intention to equals the coincidences I want in my life. So I study things. I focus in on them. I give it my think, say, do, believe, and the unconscious competencies aligned with it. So spend a minimum amount of time. You don't have to tell your wife you've done this, but you'll be surprised when you're like, hey, let's go on date night. Hey, let's go for a walk. Hey, I just wanted to call to see what I could do for you. Watch how you develop a incredibly intimate relationship with a minimum of time, as long as you do it 7 days a week and don't zero it out. Once that security is there, that you are doing what you're doing, because you have an insecurity that she doesn't appreciate that you're doing this for them, right? It's the Greatest Showman problem. If you haven't seen that movie, right. It's an entrepreneur, you're an idiot. It's my favorite movie. But, you know, he does all these things to almost lose his family. Right. I did the same thing all the way through 2006. And that movie just resonates with me. And I think it's one of the key lessons, the side hustle. Remember why you're doing it. Know your what, but remember why you're doing it and prioritize that over what you're doing.
Super, super powerful stuff here, because if you're building this business, you got to make sure that you stay true to your end goal, which I can think for most of us is to reach that level of happiness. And of course, we're talking to David Meltzer here. You can find out more at dmeltzer.com/training. Thank you so much for watching. I'm glad you enjoyed this episode. I got several other episodes right here for you. Smash one of these videos to make sure that you don't miss out on the tips, tools, and tactics of industry experts. Let's take that side hustle full time. Smash one of these links.